We don't have to perform. We will just make a film which we believe. It might work, it might not work. I think that's very important for a filmmaker. Let's do something fearless. And it's a very close story. This is a very story which is very close to me, you know. And it's a very simple, you know, love story. We wanted to make a love story with that. I was planning to work with Abir for a long time. And Padma Priya is a friend, you know, both Abir and Padma Priya, and we had fun. We discovered ourselves and our childhood through the film.
I believe this is inspired by a true story.
It's a story which happened, it's something happened to a person whom I think I know.
Abir, what was it like for you? And is it very different to be in a short film versus a feature?
See, for a short film, which I think the biggest difference is, even if we are preparing before the shoot starts, we had like 2-3 days of workshop now. But for the very first shot, you have to be bang on time. For a feature film, for me at least, we are shooting here in Kolkata for like 20-22 days at a stretch for a feature film. So it takes me at least a day or two to get into the character, to get accustomed to the character, whatever he is doing, why is he behaving like. But for a short film here in Maya, from the very first shot I have to be bang on, because we are telling a story in just 17 minutes. There are layers of emotions. And the character I played, actually the characters I played, there are two completely different characters played by the same man. So I have to be very careful about that. So from the very first shot, and as Tonita told just a few seconds back, that it was a story based on real incidents. I can still remember Tonita memorized the phone number when we were here, so you can understand how real it was. But you know, when I heard the script, I think this simplicity, which is very much missing in these days, this mystery, as she said, the mystery is also very important for our life. Put the records there, like how many minutes you talk. And I can still remember making STD calls post 9:30 because the STD rates were much lower. And like all of us who have done this, we used to talk over the phone like this because we are constantly monitoring the records there. 2 minutes, 3 minutes gone. Okay, bye. So these things, this mystery, which is very much attached to the kind of love, the kind of sentiments we have. That was my main intention. Life. That was the most attractive point of the story for me.
Ritha, would you agree with him that there isn't the time to get into character when you're in a short film?
Well, yes, I kind of, and especially if your co-actress is not somebody you can get a lot of time with to do a workshop, then of course you're on the floor. And I am so glad, like for my film, for Fool for Love, I was with somebody. In the film, we play husband and wife, and we are supposed to portray something that we have been together for years. So we are beyond that point where we are ashamed of anything in front of each other. And then there's all sort of intimacy in the film as well, in the script. There's kisses, there's making out, there's fighting, there's holding each other, like we can't let go of each other. And we had to do all those in 3 days. We had to just, yes, and continue that because the story goes, unfolds of one night. And I was very, very much at peace that I was shooting this with, and he made me super comfortable. Vice versa too, because AK was more awkward than I was and kept on saying, this is my first on-screen kiss, okay, this is my first on-screen, like, you know, bear with me. I'm like, okay, I will bear with you. So, but I think the more challenging part that way was, you know, it's okay to kiss somebody on screen, not in front of your mother, okay? So, there was my mother.
Up to that, yes, other angle.
Yes, my mother was directing it, and there she was like, you know, even there's this shot in the scene, like in the film where like we are passionately, we have met after years, you're making out and getting close to each other, and she would be like, you have to be more intimate, it's not working. I'm like, wow. So I think, yeah, and we had to because we had 3 days of time to finish up the schedule. So I think that is, I agree with Abhita that you have to, you know, be bang on at that spot, feel everything and give out your best for it to look real in the film.
Raj, what was it like for you to direct the last chapter? And, you know, what really goes into perfecting the art of making a short film?
I think what I am actually a sportsman. So I create nowadays short films to a 100 meter sprint, feature film to a middle distance running, and now web series to marathon running. So, but making a short film is tough in the sense it has its pros and cons. The pros are that you can do whatever you want and whatever subject nobody is holding you back. The cons are, one, also you have limited time. You have to say a lot of things in. Sometimes, you know, when you write a film, I wrote this film, I said, hi, 20 minutes, mein ho jayega. But when we shot it and edited it, it was 30 minutes. And it was getting boring. So we had to cut 10 minutes off it. So it has its sort of limitations. It's tough, actually, to say things in a short period of time.
Making short films, it's a it gives us the, actually the liberty, the directors. Because whenever a big amount of money is involved in making the films, in feature films mainly, then there is the question of release. That is a very big problem which we face. Here, that is the first thing which I feel as a best relief. And the second thing, there is no censorship. That is another thing which I, from my first film, I had faced a lot of times. Almost in all of my films, I have got the cuts. You know? But I'm sure this is the first time the film I have made, there is no cuts, and there are so many very intimate scenes which Ritabhari was telling that she was, actually they were pretty much her first time, they were uncomfortable because they were not, took me as the director. First she took me as the mother, mother is watching the shot in front of the monitor. Finally, it was it came very nicely because, you know, I was the director, not the mother, and so anyway, the large short films, the Royal Stag, Barrel Perfect, the large short film, they have given us this opportunity. So we are very much, I am personally, I am very much grateful to them. And this is ocean of opportunities where the directors can swim and jump and sail.
Very intimidating. What was it like for you?
This is the first short film of my life. So initially, yes, when I saw Mr. KK on the sets, I won't deny that I was a little bit intimidated, yes, because he's a fantastic actor. And to match up to that, I think it takes a whole lot of courage for almost a newcomer like me. But you know, like, this film has more to do with my life than being just another film in my life, because I have few personal reasons also for doing this film. So I think the first thing for an actor to be a part of the film is to have faith in the director. So Mr. Raj Chaudhary, I think he has been a fantastic mentor from the very beginning, when he started making the concept of the story and we discussed it and it was narrated to me. And secondly, the producer of the film, Mr. Rajesh Deora, is like a childhood friend to me. And I have always known him wanting to make something, you know, that is very unique. His idea of filmmaking is something that will create a stir in the minds of the audience. So from the very beginning, I had grave faith in the people associated with this film. So my journey became easier.